mortgage rates have been the highest since 2011. That means that depending on your credit score and your down payment, you're looking at a first mortgage rate of anywhere from low fives to as much as 6%. Now, that is an increase anywhere from $500 per month to $800 a month from what the rate would have been 2 years ago. That is a huge increase. So I have a house hack for you today. What if you were able to turn your house that you are about to buy into a portion into Airbnb and have at least 0.5% of your mortgage covered? I'm gonna show you how in this video. Stay tuned, let's get to it. Everybody, welcome to my channel. I am your host, Leo Landaverde, real estate agent and investor, helping you build wealth in real estate. If you are thinking about buying or selling real estate or want to learn more about making passive income with real estate, then you've come to the right place. And I'm going to encourage you to subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out.
Okay, guys, step number one, we got to choose our house. So I've taken the liberty to kind of give us a range of what we're looking for. You could do this in Zillow, you could do this in Trulia, you know, any of those free sites will work just fine. So what we're looking for is a house that has at least 4 bedrooms, the strategic position of the bathroom. Ideally, you want a house that has a 4th bedroom, kind of like an in-law suite with ideally separate access that you could have from the side of the house. So it could give you some privacy. That would be the ideal scenario. There are plenty of houses like that, but we're gonna try to keep this conversation simple. We're gonna look up to $500,000. We are looking in the Fresno market. So it might be a little higher in some of the other areas in California or wherever else you're watching this video around the country. 4 bedrooms. I wanted to have a pool as a draw. Having a pool is a draw. So you can definitely get a house with a pool, 4 bedrooms, and desirable areas in Fresno right now. On North Fresno for less than $500,000. So I found this house at 130 East Normal Avenue and I like it. And it's $469,900, 4 bedroom, 3 bath, 2093 square feet. I really like the pictures. It's got a good layout. Good positioning, has a pool, a lot of upgrades that have been done recently. So the house presents nice. It's basically moving condition. So with all that in mind, I think this would be a good fit. So you take one of those rooms as a house hack, and we're gonna turn it into an Airbnb. And we're gonna do it in such a way that it will help us offset or help us pay for the mortgage. Fund the mortgage, if you will. Ideally, we're looking for a way to pay for the whole mortgage with the income derived from the subsidy coming from the Airbnb. So this house will work in the area. And when it comes to Airbnb, short-term rentals, you know, you can do this in Verbo or Furnish Finder or depending on what you want to do. But legislation is everything. So if you're looking at in your local city, you want to make sure that the legislation is either established or there's no legislation or it's friendly legislation that would allow you to do this. Otherwise, you're wasting your time. You will not be able to do that legally.
Are you thinking about doing some real estate investment yourself? Let's go ahead and connect. Drop me a comment below and I'll get back to you. We'll schedule a time to chat. There are plenty of opportunities here in the Central Valley, California, that I think you need to take advantage of.
First and foremost, you want to be able to do this legally. So this particular house on the market today, as of May 3rd, 2022, is a charming Fresno High home, 4 bedrooms, 3 baths, wonderful tree-lined street, 2,100 square feet, just hits all the marks that we want. So what we're going to do next is we're going to figure out what our rate it's going to be first, and then what our mortgage payment is going to be, principal and interest only. I don't really trust, and you shouldn't really trust these estimates of mortgages just because they can be off. So what I've done is let's go to bankrate.com just to get an idea what the interest rate is at today. So we're doing a purchase at this zip code. And I don't think the zip code is relevant, But the purchase price is from the house, $469,000, as you see here, with a 5% down payment. This is gonna be an owner-occupied house hack. You're not buying it as an investment. You're actually gonna move into it. Now, if you have a property that you own and you wanna turn that into a rental, great. But what even better, if you actually own a home and wanna upgrade to this home and then take a portion of it and turn it into a short-term rental. So that's what we're talking about. This is a house hack. So 5% down is roughly about $23,450 plus closing costs, which usually range about 1% of the purchase price. So do the math. Let's just say your credit score is middle of the road, 700 to 719 on a 30-year fixed loan. We're looking at a conventional loan. We're gonna skip all of these ones on top because there are 15-year fixes and we're looking for a 30-year fix. So your base rate, 4.875, you know, 5.35. So say your actual rate was 5.375, you know, it goes up to 6.25, but it's just, it was middle of the road, 5.375. So the next thing we do is we go to our amortization schedule. Now this tool I use all the time. I will be happy to, you know, share the link with you to kind of help you do your own math. But this is how you really understand amortization, so we can get our principal and interest payment, not have the impound of the taxes and insurance. So again, 5.375 in annual interest rate. I had already done another calculation before. We're gonna calculate this. Our payment will be $2,489.35. Now, does it match to this one? $2,495, and we're looking at $2,480. That's pretty close. But what you get here is an amortization schedule that would allow you to kind of see the amortization of the loan. And the first 5 years of any mortgage loan will be heavy on the interest side, but then it kind of goes over the years, either switches to more principal payments and less interest as the years go by. So that's kind of how mortgage companies and loan companies make their money on interest upfront. So we're looking at $2,489.35 monthly PI, you know, principal and interest only. So now that we know this number, we need to figure out what is in the market for Airbnb. So we go to Airbnb. What I've done here is I actually enter Fresno, and assuming that you're gonna rent just a room or an area for up to two people, two guests coming in, whether they're coming for, you know, work or play, it doesn't really matter. What we want is the formulas. We wanna get to 70% occupancy. So we're gonna find an average rate times 70% occupancy, which it should be your goal, will give you the potential income that you're gonna make for this house hack. So what we're looking at here is, so I usually like to put the entire place, meaning that it doesn't really mean the entire house, it's the entire place. So somebody who is gonna have privacy, say there is a carve out of a room with a separate entrance, and they have, you know, access to their own room and their own shower and their own bathroom, that would be considered an entire place. I also like to, when I'm, because you know, I do Airbnb quite a bit, and I like to have places where I can actually book myself. So I'm gonna go under, and I'm gonna say that I want a instant book, which means that allows me to book myself because I have many reviews myself. So it builds trust. And I don't want to have to go back and forth with the, you know, with the host. I just want to be able to book it myself. But this is what we're looking at. We're looking at 300 stays. I haven't put any dates yet, but this just gives you an idea what the market is. And here's what you do. You click on here. It tells you that the average nightly price is $147 for up to two guests. And it gives you, you know, you have as little as, you know, maybe 60 $50, $55 per night, and as high as $385 a night. But the bulk of it, it's gonna be between, I'll say between $89 and $245. That gives you an idea what to expect. But say it was $147, take, you know, the median for all different, the 300 plus available places, say it was 147. So you take 147 times the optimal of 20 days, which is 70% occupancy, which is what super hosts are getting. And I'm a super host, so I'm getting that. So it's 2,940. That is the potential income if you do things right. So what did we say? So we're looking at $2,940 per month at 70% occupancy on a principal and interest payment of $2,489. Let's say we throw in about $1,000 a year of fire insurance, and say your taxes are, and particularly where I'm at is about 1.25. So 1.25 or 469,000. $5,800 divided by 12, so that's another 488, so another 5. So you're gonna be you're basically gonna be almost rent-free on your own property, and that's how you do it. So you start looking for a house, has to have at least 4 bedrooms. Now, depending on the size of your family, if your family is smaller, and then you may be able to find a 3-bedroom house, that will work, but you gotta have a dedicated space. Then I don't like this thing about sharing space. I think a lot of people don't like sharing space. So that's what I look for, properties that have a guest house or a detached garage or a separate in-law suite. Those are really, really, really good for Airbnb. So hopefully this video helps you. And this is the time for house hacks. And please reach out to me. Let me know if you have any questions. I'd love to be able, if you're in the Central Valley, particularly in Fresno, I'd love to help you get yourself a house that where you can actually turn it into an Airbnb. All right. Thank you so much for letting me share.
For a limited time, I'm giving away a couple of my everyday tools. One is the maximum mortgage payment calculator, and the other one is my house flipping calculators. These are workbooks in Excel that I use every day as I'm looking for deals for either me or my clients. They're my gift to you. All you need to do is follow in the notes section of this video, and you're gonna find the links to download them. They are yours to keep. Hope you enjoy them. Thank you very much.